Welcome to the video tutorial on how to build a server to share files via the web on a Windows computer. With this method, you are not limited by space and bandwidth. Watch this video until the end to see how easy it is to share files over the web. In this video, I use HTTP file server to create a web server. It is also known as HFS. You access the link in the description and download the Windows version. HFS not only supports Windows but also has versions for Linux or macOS. After downloading and extracting, I moved HFS to Windows C partition for long-term use. To use HFS, you just need to double-click the executable file. Don't forget to allow HFS through the Windows firewall to allow remote computers or phones to access the server. This is a web interface that helps me configure a web server to share files. First, I integrated HFS into the Windows system to easily add files or shared folders. Now on my Windows computer, I add a new folder and start sharing files. I added a new folder named netvn. To add a folder to the shared server, I just right-click on the target folder and click Add to HFS. Immediately on the HFS management page, a shared folder named netvn appeared. I recommend that you create permissions for shared folders to improve security. So I created a new account with the username netvn. After completing the creation of the new account, I will assign permissions to the newly shared folder. The newly created account has all rights to the shared folder named netvn. These are the basic steps to start sharing files over the web. To test, I open a web browser and access using the IP address. Then logging in using the newly created account, I accessed the shared folder. If you find it interesting, don't forget to like and subscribe. Next, I upload any file. You can upload files of folders. For each file or folder, you can create a comment for it. Or you can directly play video files or show image files. Not only upload, but I can also download files from this web server. But at this step, the web server can only share files within the local network. You cannot access it from the internet. The next steps, I show you how to share files over the internet with this web server. To access shared files, you set up port forwarding on the router. Or you use VPN for remote access. In this video, I use port forwarding on the router to ensure bandwidth. On the router, forward port 80 to the IP address of the Windows computer. Make sure your Windows computer is assigned a static IP address. Because my computer doesn't have a static IP address set up yet, I'll do that. After completing setting up a static IP address from my Windows computer and port forwarding on the router, I can access shared files from anywhere. You can test the connection from the internet to this web server right on the control panel. I use a dynamic public IP address so it changes over time. To fix this, I use a public IP address update service. The dynamic domain name service I use is called DYNU. It will give you a free domain name and a tool to help you map the public IP address and that domain name. After mapping the domain name to the public IP address, now from the internet I access the shared files using the domain name. When you transfer files over the internet, I recommend that you encrypt the data. To encrypt, you just need to enable HTTPS on HFS. HTTPS needs a certificate to work. The easiest way is to make a self-signed certificate. This isn't perfect, but it's easy to set up and tailored to individual needs. To update the public IP address every time it changes, install the above software. This software automatically maps the IP address and domain name every time it changes. Now you only need to remember the domain name, which is easier than having to remember the public IP address. Because I now use HTTPS to access files shared over the internet, on the router I forward one more port. On the router I forward port 443 to the Windows computer's IP address. On the admin page, I again verify the connection from the internet to the web server sharing this file. Verified successfully, I have completed building a file sharing server that can be accessed from anywhere. Whenever you access the server from your local network or from the internet, you use HTTPS. You can also monitor connections, bandwidth, or change the language if you want. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe. There is another tip I want to introduce to you. Set up HFS to run automatically every time you turn on your Windows computer. You follow these steps. You create a new shortcut to run HFS. You create a shortcut that runs an executable file. After you finish creating the new shortcut, just move it to the folder named Startup on your Windows computer. So every time you turn on your Windows computer, HFS automatically runs. I use an Android phone connected to the internet using mobile data. So I can only access the file sharing web server over the internet. On my Android phone, I open any browser and access the web server using the domain name. I am then forwarded to a website that uses HTTPS. Next, I used the account created in the previous step to access the shared folder. On my Android phone, I upload some photos to the server. I uploaded 3 photos. As you can see on your Windows computer, the files have been uploaded successfully. Good luck.